So in today's lecture, we are going to cover the following topics. Number one, it is a unit step signal, then sinusoidal signal, then unit ramp signal, signum function, unit impulse signal, then exponential signal, and last one is sinc function. Now let's see some commonly used standard signal. Number one is unit step signal, in which we will discuss first the continuous time unit step signal, that is represented by U function of t, and second one is discrete time unit step signal, which is represented by U function of n. Now first we will discuss about the continuous time unit step signal. So unit step signal is defined as u function of t is equals to 1 for t greater than equal to 0 and 0 for t less than 0. That means हम लोग का जो unit step signal है ये exist करेगा, इसका amplitude क्या रहेगा, 1 रहेगा for time greater than equal to 0 और 0 रहेगा for time less than 0. तो हम लोग ये figure में देख सकते हैं, this is x of t is यहाँ पे क्या है unit step u of t, और ये क्या है टाइम है अपना t is टाइम. सो हमारा जो एम्पलीट्यूड है फ्रॉम हियर टू हियर ये क्या है 1 है. तो यहाँ पे हम लोग का t यहाँ पे इस पर्टिकुलर पोजीशन में क्या है, इस पर्टिकुलर पोजीशन में t इज इक्वल टू 0 है. सिमिलरली और इस डायरेक्शन में जैसे 0 के इस साइड जा रहे हैं तो हम लोग का t का वैल्यू क्या है, t इज greater than 0. तो t greater than और equal to 0 में हम लोग का क्या है ut का वैल्यू क्या होगा, 1 रहेगा. ठीक है, सिमिलरली अगर हम लोग लेफ्ट हैंड साइड में देखें, लेफ्ट हैंड साइड ऑफ द ग्राफ देखें इस डायरेक्शन में, तो इस डायरेक्शन में क्या है t is less than 0 है. हियर t इज लेस देन 0, अगर t इज लेस देन 0 है तो u ऑफ t इस डायरेक्शन में क्या होगा, इस डायरेक्शन में u ऑफ t होगा आपका, इट विल बी इक्वल्स टू 0. सिमिलरली फॉर डिस्क्रीट टाइम सिग्नल, इट इज स्पेसिफाइड एट अ डिस्क्रीट इंटरवल ऑफ टाइम, यूनिट स्टेप विल बी स्पेसिफाइड एट अ डिस्क्रीट इंटरवल ऑफ टाइम. सो इट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय, इट इज डिफाइंड एज u ऑफ n इक्वल्स टू 1 फॉर n ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू 0 और 0 फॉर n लेस देन 0. सिमिलर है, सेम कंटिन्यूस टाइम सिग्नल के लिए जैसा है वैसा ही है, बट यहाँ पे क्या है डिस्क्रीट इंटरवल ऑफ टाइम में हमारा 1 रहेगा u ऑफ n का वैल्यू. तो यहाँ पे हम लोग देख सकते हैं इस ग्राफ में क्या है, तो यहाँ पे ये क्या है हमारा u ऑफ n और n के बीच में है, n हमारा इंटीजर हमें पता है, तो n जो है यहाँ पे, तो फॉर n ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू 0 इस डायरेक्शन में क्या है हमारा, इस डायरेक्शन में आपका है n इज ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू 0. तो ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू 0 में हम लोग का क्या है, हम लोग का u ऑफ n क्या होगा, u ऑफ n होगा आपका, इट विल बी इक्वल्स टू 1. सिमिलरली इस डायरेक्शन में क्या होगा, इस डायरेक्शन में आपका होगा u ऑफ n इज इक्वल्स टू 0 बिकॉज हियर n इज लेस देन 0. Now the second signal is sinusoidal signal. So sinusoidal signal includes what? Cosine and sine. Sine signals are all sinusoidal signal. So first we will discuss about the continuous time sinusoidal signal that is represented by x of t, and then we will discuss about discrete time sinusoidal signal that is represented by x of n. So x of t, continuous time sinusoidal signal x of t represented as, it is equals to a sine omega t equals to a sine 2 pi f omega, where omega is the angular frequency, a is the amplitude, t is the time. So it is represented by like this, the continuous time sinusoidal signal is represented like this. So where amplitude, this is the amplitude this is nothing but this is A, this one is A, this is amplitude, and the time period is represented by this, from here to here, from 0 to T, this is the time period of sine wave. Similarly, for the discrete time signal, it is represented by x of n equals to a sine omega n, where n is the integer. We have already discussed discrete signals only specified at a discrete interval of time. So it will be represented like this. It will be represented like dotted this line. Hope you have understand. Now let's see the third one, that is unit ramp signal. So first one is continuous time unit ramp signal, which is denoted by R function of t. So it is defined as R function of t is equals to t for t greater than equal to 0 and 0 for t less than equal to 0, or we can write it like this, that is R of t is equals to t u of t, because we know that u of t is 1 for t greater than equal to 0 and 0 for t less than 0. So we can write it as this also. It is representing nothing but this thing and this thing are same, so don't get confused. Now further, if we can see the unit ramp signal, x of the continuous time unit ramp signal denoted by R of t is represent like this. This linear curve is nothing but a unit ramp signal. Similarly, for discrete time signal, it is defined as R of n is equals to n for n greater than equals to 0 and 0 for n less than 0, and or we can write it like this, R of n equals to n u of n. Now the discrete time signal will be plot like this. So it is R of n, here it is x of n, sorry, it is x of n, this is nothing but x of n is equals to R of n. It is 0, here it is 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. In this way we will represent. Now the fourth one is signum function. Now let's see the continuous time signum function, which is represented by SGN function of t. Similarly, discrete time signum function represented by SGN function of n. So it is defined as continuous time signum function is defined as x of t equals to SGN t is equals to 1 for t greater than 0 and minus 1 for t less than 0. So it is represented like this. So we can see that for t greater than 0, here in this direction the value of SGN is equals to 1. Similarly, in this direction the signum function value is minus of 1. Similarly, for discrete time signal, this is defined as x of n equals to SGN function of n equals to 1 for n greater than 0 and minus 1 for n less than 0. It is represented like this. So here also same thing, the value of xn is 1 for n greater than equal to 0 and for n less than 0 it is minus of 1. Now the fifth one is unit impulse signal. Sometime it is also called as a delta signal. So it is very important function used किसलिए use करते हैं for the analysis of the communication signal के analysis के लिए हम लोग use करते हैं. So first we will discuss about the continuous time unit impulse signal which is denoted by del of t. So continuous time unit impulse signal is defined as del of t is equals to 1 for t equals to 0 and 0 for t not equals to 0. It is represented like this. So it is a plot between del function of t and t. So it is represented like this. It is present only at t equals to 0. And its amplitude at t equals to 0 is infinitely large, so that the area under the pulse is unity. Due to the unity area, इसका area क्या unity है, इसलिए हम लोग इसको क्या बोलते हैं, unit impulse function. Now let's see the discrete time unit impulse signal. It is defined as del of n equals to 1 for n equals to 0 and 0 for n not equals to 0. It is represented like this. So here we can see that here it is 1, but for the value of n greater than 0, it is del of n value is 0, and for n less than 0, del of n value is 0. So note, the area under the unit impulse is given by integral minus infinity to infinity del of t dt equals to 1. So area under the unit impulse is given by minus infinity to infinity del of t is equals to 1, because for t less than 0 it is 0, for t greater than 0 is also it's 0. Only it is present at t equals to 0. So the area under a unit impulse is 1. Now let's see the sixth one, exponential signal, which is represented by x of t equals to a e to the power alpha t, where a and alpha are real number. So for alpha equals to 0, it will be represented like this. For alpha equals to 0, x of t will be always equals to a, because if alpha equals to 0 and we put 0 over here, then what we will get? We will get x of t is equals to a. So it is represented like this. Similarly, for the alpha greater than equal to 0, it will be represented like this. That is, when the alpha value is greater than 0, then the x of t will be equals to a e to the power alpha t. We will get e to the power alpha t. So it will be a rising exponential function. We can see that it is a rising exponential function. Similarly, when the alpha is less than 0, then we will get this type of function. So this is nothing but when, because when alpha is less than 0, then x of t and x of t will be equals to what? Will be equals to a e to the power minus alpha t. So we will get a decaying exponential function. It is nothing but decaying exponential function. Now let's see the seventh one, that is sinc function. It is expressed, mathematically expressed as sinc function of t is equals to sine function of pi t divided by pi t. It is represented, this function is represented like this. So here at t equals to 0, sinc function of t is 1, and at sinc t is 0, at t is plus minus 1, at particular point this plus minus 2 is also 0, plus minus 3, value of sinc t function t is 0, similarly plus minus 4 is also 0. And so we can see and observe that the mathematical function that we have plotted, that shown over here in this figure, that the amplitude goes on decreasing as the value of t is increasing. As the value of t is goes on increasing in this direction, the amplitude is goes on, amplitude of the signal is goes on decreasing.